1944. For 5 long years, Europe has been under the yoke of Nazi oppression. Ruling the continent with an iron fist, Hitler seemed to have crushed all hope that the forces of tyranny would be defeated. But on June 6, 1944, the dreams of freedom and justice were rekindled when Anglo-American forces landed in Normandy, France, set on freeing the continent from the German horde. City by city, town by town, Allied forces raced across France and Western Europe, liberating the people who for so long had been occupied by their German enemies. Allied forces advanced rapidly, speeding across the plains of Western Europe in a matter of months. In August, Allied forces captured thousands of German troops and inflicted 466,000 German casualties. Meanwhile, the Russians on the Eastern Front had advanced to the border of the Reich itself. The tyranny of fascism and the rule of the Nazis was on the retreat. Allied forces had advanced rapidly across the plains of Western Europe. So rapidly that in September 1944, Allied forces had to stop the advance of the German border to allow supplies to catch up with the advanced units. Allied morale was high. The German forces were reeling from their massive defeat in France that summer, and things were faring even worse for the Germans on the Eastern Front. The Allied soldiers settled in, thinking all that was left was a victorious march to Berlin, and they would all be back home for Christmas.
During this time, Hitler began meeting with his generals to discuss plans for a German counterattack. Secretly, the Germans had been constructing a massive force for such an attack. Hitler planned to advance to the port of Antwerp, cutting off Allied armies from their supplies. He hoped this would prompt Western Allied leaders to desire a compromise and form a peace treaty with the Germans. Then, with peace on the Western Front, he would be able to concentrate the main forces of his armies against the Russians in the East. Hitler chose the Ardennes Forest for the attack due to the fact that the majority of Allied forces holding it were either inexperienced or battle-weary. Under the cover of fog, German forces massed near the Ardennes Forest, awaiting the orders for attack. The German offensive was planned for December 16, 1944, a day in which all Allied planes would be grounded due to bad weather. Due to Allied air superiority, the Germans had to advance quickly and under the cover of fog in order for their blitzkrieg to succeed. In order for the German offensive to succeed, German forces had to take control of the Ardennes roads so that the German divisions could advance more quickly to Meuse River and later on to Antwerp. The roads in the forest were narrow and all met up in the cities of Bastion and Saint-Vit. Control of these two cities would grant access to the Ardennes road network and were vital to the Germans in order to advance quickly. On December 16, 1944, at 0500, German artillery opened fire on the Ardennes Forest. German forces advanced on an 85-mile front. American forces, outnumbered and outgunned, fought ferociously. Cut off and surrounded, some American forces surrendered to the Germans, only to find an icy execution at the hands of their conquerors. However, most troops fought on bravely, not giving the Germans a single inch of ground without a fight. The determined resistance of these American forces caused the Germans to advance more slowly, losing the element of surprise and valuable time.
After 3 days of intense fighting, American forces had begun to give ground. Allied leaders met on December 19, 1944, to discuss a battle strategy against the Germans. Allied commanders agreed that the cities of Saint-Vit and Bastion would be the locations of the most determined Allied resistance. These cities would be held as long as possible against the Germans, while at the same time, General Patton's army would advance north to cut off the Germans and relieve these cities. The first city to be reached by the Germans was Saint-Vit. After hours of intense combat, the American forces abandoned the city on December 21st. The German plan required the city to be taken on the 17th, but due to its fierce defense and the brave actions of American soldiers, the Germans were delayed, costing them valuable time and troops. After the fall of Saint-Vit, German forces reached the city of Bastion, surrounding it on December 21st. The city had been reinforced by the 101st Airborne Division and retreating American forces. The Germans, outnumbering the defenders greatly, were faced with determined American resistance and were unable to take the city, having to instead siege the defenders, costing them time and delaying the Germans even more. American forces, surrounded in Bastion and still without air support, continued to hold out against the German siege. As Patton's forces raced northward to relieve the city, the Germans tried once more to capture the city and its vital roads. The Germans sent a message to the American forces, asking for the surrender of the city. The American commander, reading this, replied, "Nuts," defying the Germans. As German forces continually tried to break their way through the Ardennes and capture the road junction at Bastion, the weather began to clear, and on December 23, 1944, Allied planes took to the skies, plaguing German troops and halting their advance, still miles away from the Meuse River and days from Antwerp. On December 26, 1944, Patton's forces reached the city of Bastion, relieving the beleaguered Americans and driving back the Germans. The German offensive had done little more than create a bulge in the Allied lines and caused mass German losses. By February 1945, the American lines were back to their position that they were prior to the attack. The Battle of the Bulge was over. The conflict known as the Battle of the Bulge was Hitler's last-ditch effort to compromise with Allied leaders and preserve his rule of Germany. With German losses numbering over 100,000, Germany had lost any hope of defending the Reich effectively. The Battle of the Bulge destroyed any possibility of a German compromise and left open the only option for Germany, unconditional surrender, which was signed on May 8, 1945, ending the war in Europe and destroying Nazi Germany.